Welcome back. It's not the oldest profession around, but it's not far off, and yet it feels like it's never been more popular.
Men are flocking to barbershops after decades of sitting in hair salons. Mike Thorpe booked in with two shops at either end of their growth.
I've been cutting hair for like 10 years plus.
5 years. I started in 1965.
For centuries, these three colours have signified men cutting men's hair.
Men went to men's hairdressers and that was it.
Actually, they performed surgery too.
I mean, I think barbers used to pull teeth. Thank God we don't do that anymore.
When I started, men came in every 2-3 weeks for short back and sides.
Up the wall, is what they used to call it, yeah.
And it's back in fashion.
Skin fades, super short, super tight, is probably the main cut we do these days. You know, side parts, slick backs. Traditional styles, but with like a new, I guess, new take to it.
Mullets are sort of working their way back in, like fashionable mullets. It's the whole thing of getting more metro. I just see it going more and more, like guys will be getting their eyebrows waxed, shaped, more and more and more.
John remembers the last time that men embraced their feminine side.
It went through the stage of the late 60s, 70s into the long hair, and that really changed things.
Yeah, for a long time, New Zealand was sort of kind of, you were stuck going to your sort of your girlfriend's salon or your mum's salon and getting the old four back and sides and not liking it, you know?
I got three brothers. My mum cut all of our hair till I was 20.
But in 2019, the barber is back in vogue. For men, by men.
You go into a barbershop, there's so many walks of life, different people, different dudes, but they seem to all, you know, be attracted to the same thing.
A place for guys to hang out that felt comfortable. Like going to someone's house, watch sport, play video games, have banter with my mates.
Banter. That's changed a bit too.
Oh, you would have more political talk these days than what you used to have.
It's usually jokes. It's all jokes.
No, people tell you everything. You know, it's quite amazing at times. A lot of it you wouldn't believe.
Because I'm talking all day, I come home to my girlfriend and she's like, how's your day? I don't want to talk to you. I've been talking all day long, you know?
Within these stark four walls, John's heard it all.
It was actually where I used to get my hair cut here as a boy. 1967, started here.
Wow.
Yeah. Bit of a worry, isn't it? And I've been here ever since.
It's pretty impressive to go through so many, yeah, I guess, eras of cutting and keep with it.
I think it's crazy. I think it's awesome that he like loved his job to work 50 years.
But just as the trend moves back to barbering, John has been forced to move on. His lease terminated.
What are you going to miss most, mate?
Oh, meeting people. Just sorry that I haven't got time to, or the chance more than the time to say thank you very much for your loyal support. Yes. Yeah, I just won't see them again.
As the barber trade loses a legend, it's up to the next generation to continue centuries of service.
I don't know if I'll do 50.
I love my job, but like, holy crap, 50 years is insane.
It's what I really wanted to do, and I'm very, very lucky to have the chance, and good people have supported me.
So the amazing thing too is that the fastest growing sector of personal care and beauty products, not women, but men. And barber graduates have more than quadrupled in the past decade, and still the industry is struggling to keep up with staffing demands. Mm-hmm. Why are you smiling?
I'm just kind of laughing. It doesn't surprise me.
Male beauty products?
Male beauty products. More and more men are taking pride in the way that they look, Hillary, their personal appearance.
Well, I can see hair products are a big thing.
Well, there's a bit of hair product in this particularly. Here, actually, I'll tell you who's a pet project of mine, Andrew Saville. From Sport, Sport Reader.
Why? What have you two got going on?
Well, he said to me the other day he was complaining about his dryness of his skin. So I said, I put him onto a moisturiser.
Really?
Yep.
Take me through it, because I'm sort of imagining where does this discussion take place?
In the TVNZ locker room. You're not allowed in there because it's the men's locker room, of course.
Okay.
And so I'm not allowed in the women's locker room.
What are you going to that?
We have segregated locker rooms.
It's fine. So you got your locker room, and Andrew goes, gee, Jeremy, my skin's dry.
I'm feeling a bit dry. And I said, have you used a moisturiser, Andrew? And he said, no, I don't, actually. He said, I find them a bit greasy, a bit oily. And I said, well, I'll tell you what, I've got this one here. It's not greasy at all. And so he tried it. He said, oh, this is nice. And I thought, oh, I'll get him some. So I bought him some.
Oh, did you really? That's lovely.
Yeah, a little present for Andrew Saville.
That's super. Where'd you get it from?
I got it from...
Oh, down the road.
Down the road.
Yeah, because I told you, don't go duty-free.
No, I won't go duty-free.
It's not cheaper duty-free.
No.
You heard it from me first. Don't be doing all that duty-free shopping, apart from the spirits, that's quite good. And the we're not allowed to say it on air.
Those are our people today. That was 7 Sharp Tonight.
Paramedics is next. We will see you tomorrow. Cheerio.